May peace be unto you, my beloved. How are you? I know things are moving on better as I am doing here. I am Reverend Charles Sajani Mbwatin, your faithful servant. Nana Ebertoda the second. We are about to share the word together. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Holy Spirit. Come and minister unto thy children. Use me to bless them this day in the name of Jesus. I am to share with you, acknowledge the Holy Spirit. Acknowledge the Holy Spirit. In terms of everything, you have to acknowledge the Holy Spirit. To acknowledge means to know Holy Spirit personal. You have to know Holy Spirit personally. Not allow anyone to describe him to you, but rather you to know Holy Spirit. So the question is, who is the Holy Spirit to you? No. Not to everyone, but to you. Who is he? The Holy Spirit should not just be part of the Christian jargon you use. Listen to it. The Holy Spirit, it shouldn't be just part of the Christian jargon you use. Instead, he should be front and center in your life. He should be all things and everything. That's why you must always acknowledge him. To acknowledge the Holy Spirit is to identify and recognize who he is and the role he plays in your life. And when you do, you must say it out loud as part of your fellowship with him. And each morning, you can tell him who he is and what he means to you. It will make a world of difference. It will make a world of difference. The more you recognize him, the more he becomes effective in your life. I pray that your partnership in the faith may become effective as you fully acknowledge every good thing that is ours in Christ. In Philemon chapter 1, verse number 6, I read again. I pray that your partnership in the faith may become effective as you fully acknowledge every good thing that is ours in Christ. Have you acknowledged the Holy Spirit this morning? Is he the front and center of everything you are doing? Let me leave you with this last verse. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. In Proverbs chapter 3, verse number 6. You have to acknowledge the Holy Spirit in all times so that he can do a miracle for you. I just want to leave you here. But what I want to tell you is, I love you. Shalom, peace. Here is the voice of your faithful servant, Reverend Charles Ajeni Mbwatin. Let's make it another day. Bye-bye.